Hey, Michelle. Good morning. Here we are at the Zero Start 30 game with the Birmingham Bulls blue team taking on Center Ice. Bulls dropped two games yesterday, 7-3 against the Atlanta Phoenix, and the other one was 5-4 against the Knoxville Ice Bears. We have two games today, one at right now at dark 30, sun's not even up, it's currently 7 degrees here in Pelham. Much needed rain last night, and later today I believe at 10 o'clock. On a change up in goalie today, looks like we're going to have number 87, Bryce Coyle, in his goalie for this morning. Little switch in the uniforms today as Bulls will be wearing darker colors, blue, and Center Ice will be wearing white. Center Ice defeated the Mad Hatters yesterday soundly, 7-1. Here we go, period one, in the 13-minute period. Starting lineup, John Michael Mogavero at center ice with Aiden Skogel, number 14, right wing. Left wing is going to be Kellen McNutt. On defense, we have Matt Kinsey with Jackson Joyner joining him. Bulls fighting for it in the neutral zone. Aiden Skoglund is skating with the puck. He's got Kellen McNutt. He picks it up. Takes a shot. Oh, it's bounced off the goalie, but not in. Having a little trouble turning the camera. Here we go. Kenzie's got it. Takes a shot. It's high. Like your sponsor, Southwest. Sponsors Bulls team. Bulls have had 3 shots on goal so far in a very short amount of time. There's another shot, but it's blocked by a Bulls player. Center ice picks up, starts to try to skate out with it. The Rays there sends it in with a backhander. Mugavero tries to fight for a long boards. Takes another shot in the goal, he covers. Both teams make the line changes. Face off in the center ice on offensive zone. Thomas takes it. William Therrien has it. Tries a pass there. Draws is picked off by center ice. We now have a breakaway by center ice. And there's a goal by center ice on a breakaway. So center ice 1, Bulls 0 with 11:50. Left in the first period. Center ice wins the faceoff. Cal Lane tries to send him back into the neutral zone, which he does. It's fight with along the boards. William Therrien tries to get on for the puck. Bulls are trying to maintain possession. Therrien battles along the board, just tries to keep it pinned. Thompson comes in and helps him out to send into center ice defensive zone. And it's a steal off a bad pass. Thompson takes a shot, like a pass, but it's blocked by center ice. Center ice just instantly takes it to the neutral zone. A bad pass, Cal Lane tries to play off the boards. Sends it to Joyner. Joyner's skating up. Deeks one defenseman. Got the goal on the side, takes a shot, and it's left of the goal. John Michael Mugavero has the puck. Oh, center ice, a little stick check. Dylan Ray sends it back in. John Michael brought to his knees, still trying to make a play for the puck. Center ice sends it forward, but Dylan Ray keeps it in. He skates with it, keeping it along the board, keeps fighting for it. Number 6 center ice gets it, sends it back over. And Therrien sends it over to John Michael. The Deeks one defender takes shot. Oh, and it's off the pad of the goalie. But another shot on goal. Bulls trying to keep it in. The center ice manages to get it. He just shoots it up ice. Ray skates with it, trying to shake the defender off of him. Ray sends it back to the point. Bulls take a shot. It's blocked. Foul is along the boards. He's going to come out with it. John Michael has it. No offsides. Kellen McNutt. Later there. Trying to make something happen. The puck traveled a little too fast. John Michael trying to sell it down. Center ice winds up getting it. Seems like every time 88 touches the puck, you got about the whole state of Tennessee on top of him. Center ice tries to send a pass, but Eric Graw's there to block it. Number 88, center ice steps in to keep the hopes alive for center ice here. Bulls go in for a line change. Center ice tries to get it across the neutral zone. Eric Graw picks it up. The battle tied up in skates. Little Pele action going on from Thompson. Cowling trying to send it to the wall to Skoglund. Having a little trouble. And the Joyner gets a hold of it. Can he beat the defender there? He tries. Knocks the defender down. Tries to backhand it out. Doesn't get it out. Now they're both down on the ground. And the Bulls will have the first faceoff of the game in their own zone. Bulls are down 1-0 here in the first period with 8 minutes and 30 seconds left. Trying to send it to the center ice zone. Bulls are trying to fight for it here. The shot, it's wide of the net. Wynn Laird goes behind, pick it up. Sends it out. Kenzie tries his best to keep it in, and he does. Center ice picks up behind their own net. Wynn Theron trying to make a play for the puck. Wynn Laird steps up, the defender. Bulls are doing a good job of keeping it in. They just put a little bit of pressure to the net. They do have 4 shots on goal to center ice's 1. And that 1 shot on goal led. Oh, Dylan with a great play to try to keep it in, but it doesn't. Yep. Wynn Laird is called offsides. Sun is still not up here in Pelham. Bulls, shots on goal 4, center ice 1, score 1-0. Face off center ice. Center ice wins it. That's going to get confusing saying that. Center ice. So Eric Braw skates with it. Got 2 defenders on him. Allen comes in to help him out. Battle for it. They're both hung up together. Give up in front of the net, but the Bulls clear it out. Kellen McNutt's got time and space, and here he goes. He's trying to put on the Jets. Gets it up to the boards. Takes a shot, but it's blocked by number 9 from center ice. On the ground, but the Bulls keep it in. Cavaline sends it back up the boards. Thompson's got the puck now. He takes a shot, and it's sailed and stopped by the goalie from center ice. A few more of those looks, and I predict a Bulls goal in the next 2 minutes with 6 minutes and 55 seconds left. John Michael takes the faceoff, wins it. Eric Gross sends a puck. Oh, and it's stopped by the goalie. 1 second, 1 inch. Would have been a goal. Puck is dropped. Bulls win it. John Michael sends it back to Catalane. Eric Gross fires it in. Oh, another shot on goal, but a save by the goalie. Applying pressure. Winning faceoffs. Feel something's about to happen here. Bulls win another faceoff. John Michael sends it back over. There's a shot. It's deflected and a stop again by the goalie. Deflection. Ray with the shot and a deflection by, I believe, Wynn Theron. Almost sent it in. There we go. Face off. Bulls win it again. Dylan Ray has it. Sends it over to Kenzie. Not too much on the puck. Sends it back over, and it's now out, so the Bulls have to recoil. Now we got an interference call on Dylan Ray, number 23. Don't quite agree with that. So it's going to be a 1 minute, 30-second penalty with 6:22 left in the first. Bulls down by 1. They're now on the power play. Bulls win the faceoff. Bulls are now on the power play. John Michael picks it up, but again, he's swarmed as soon as he touches the puck. Center ice skates with it, trying to get this power play goal. They've only had 1 shot on goal, which resulted in a goal. It was a breakaway. It was a player down from center ice, fell under his own demand. The Bulls have a very aggressive penalty kill at times. Let's see if they go with the aggressive side or stay back more conservative. There's a blocked shot by Eric Gross staying in there, taking a hit. Bulls just trying to get it cleared out now. And here we go. This could be it. John Michael skating with it. He's got William Therrien to his left. Moving up five center. The pass, but it's broken up. And it's offsides by the Bulls. 42 seconds left in the penalty kill. Dylan Ray in the box for interference. I don't agree with. I believe both were skating towards the puck. And body contact happens in the sport. And the puck is dropped. Center ice wins it. Graw steps in, trying to make something happen, and he does. Thompson sends it up ice. And center ice is going to have to recoil to figure out what they're going to do. They decide to skate with it out. It's sent neutral zone, but Graw decides to kill a little bit of time, go behind his own net, stop for a minute, pivot. Ooh, lift it up, just like Southwest Airlines, taking flight. One of the Bulls' sponsors, Eric, picks it back up. Trying to kill time. 9 seconds left on this penalty kill. Catalan gets it, and the penalty kill's over. Dylan Ray's back on the ice. And he's got the puck, and he sends it up to Kellen McNutt. It's off his skate. The center ice is going to get to it first. The Bulls are applying pressure, and it's stopped by Thompson. It's kept in the zone. What a good stop with his skates. Dylan Ray's trying to get it, keep it in there. Using a little Pele skills with a stick. Thompson steps up, but center ice Dixie Moe, and there's a cutoff in the neutral zone by Kenzie. The Bulls are applying force here now. 1-0 in the first. Shots on goal again. 7 by the Bulls and 1 by center ice, which was a breakaway goal here in the early wee hours of Sunday morning. There was a shot wide trying to get a deflection, but nobody's there for center ice. Here we go. We could have something here. Ray skating when he's by himself, trying to make a play. And he, the Bulls can't keep it in. Wynn's got to get all, he's got to get back over, and it's going to be offsides by the Bulls. Center ice supposed to get in line, changes in. 3 minutes and 43 seconds left in the first period. And the puck is dropped. John Michael wins it. Him and Aiden Skuglin skate up, and there's a shot. It's up high, but it's stopped by center ice goalie. A little bit of back and forth here in the first. Solid goal coming from a breakaway by center ice, but there's been a lot of shots on goal by the Bulls, a lot of solid wins on faceoff. Keep them in it. And that's a shot deflected in front of the net. Aiden Skoglund trying to get to it. Gets a little stick on it, keep it in. Gross sends it up, it's bouncing to Skoglund. Oh, he takes a turn. John Michael tries to get it on, he runs it to the goalie. He's trying to get back up, but center ice recovers the puck. Bulls had some good shots on goal. Currently add that one more to the total. Center ice has it. Oh, and Catalan just comes in and represents. All right, and here we go. Catalan skating with it. He's getting Joyner to follow him and take it in as the Bulls get a line change. Center ice follows suit, and a shot by Catalan. It's blocked by the goalie, but a good shot nonetheless. Bulls are desperately trying to get a goal here towards the end of this first. We have 2 minutes and 15 seconds, and it's knocked out. Number 10 from center ice is looking for some support. He can't find it. He takes a shot, trying to get a pass over to somebody in front of him, but nobody was there. Center ice banks it back in. There's 2 minutes left in the period. Graz shoots it up. It's knocked out. We got a foot race for the puck, but center ice winds up getting it. With a cutoff by William Therrien. No offsides caller. He's fighting. He gets knocked down. Center ice recovers the puck. Goes behind it on the net. Tries to get it out. And it's knocked out. The Bulls are trying to... Looks like we're going to have an offsides again. There's 1 minute and 35 seconds left here in the first. So again, Bulls, 10 shots on goal, center ice, one. And that's where the long goal came from. If the Bulls keep applying pressure like this, it won't be no time before they have it. Skoglund knocks it into the zone. Center ice goes behind the net, but he's met by Kellen McNutt. Skates into the stick, trying to get it. But bounces off the sixth man. Aiden Skoglund picks up, keeps it in the zone, tries to keep it. Kellen McNutt has it, number eight. It's a fight for it. Bulls are trying to keep it in, and it's finally knocked out. Battle on the boards with Kinsey. Good pass to Thompson, and a pass between the skates of McNutt, and he would have had a breakaway. Beautiful pass from Ray to McNutt. Can't quite keep it in. McNutt to Thompson. He skates with it. He's double-teamed. Wynn Lair's there to chase the puck behind the net. Ray goes in, trying to keep the puck in, and he does. He keeps the puck in, but they're both down, so it's all for naught. Reading up the last 30 seconds. Joyner now joins the ice. Thompson, but it's going to be an offsides. Seconds left here in the first. Bulls down by one, trying to get it back. Good defensive stand there by the Bulls. Cross sends it up. Oh, here we go. This could be something. No offsides. And that's it. Just as Michael Magavero was trying to get in the zone, couldn't happen. So now we'll take a short little break and begin the second period. Bulls down by one. Shots on goal, though, favor the Bulls 10-1. A single goal coming from that breakaway in the first 30 seconds of the game. The Bulls implied solid pressure. They can just keep it going. I predict pretty hot second period. Had one penalty for the Bulls on number 23, Ray, for interference. I do not believe that was a good call. Sun is still not up here in Pelham. Osama bin Laden was killed, matter of fact, later than this. That's how early it is here in Pelham. The buzzer, that's going to be the start of the second period. Again, a 13-minute period here. This is first weekend of league play here in Pelham, the Civic Complex. Bulls 10U Blues team lost two games today. Too many on the ice. And there we go, it's face off. The Bulls win it solidly. And we're back into play. Hostetter takes it. He's going to call some skates. They're trying to make a play happen. They're set up. Wynn Lair, number 50, goes in there. Knocked the puck. 61, recoils. Tries to send it to the slot. Trying to get it to John Michael. Ooh, Ray with a dive to keep it in, and it's going to be offsides. There we go, face off. Bulls win it. The nut skating with it in between the skates of a player. He's on his knees trying to make a play. Aiden Skoglund fights for the puck, gets it over to Thompson. Thompson trying to get room, and a backhander by Minot, but he falls as he shoots. Skoglund sends it over to Callane. Callane takes a shot, but it's blocked by number 10 from center ice. Center ice recovers the puck, tries to send it over, but the Bulls recover. Gross skates with it. He's taking it the distance. Tries to get it over to Thompson, but there's traffic in the area. Battle for it here in the neutral zone. Callane sends it back over to Gross. There's three guys. They can just get it between them. They have a cherry picker goal right here. Bulls got to keep it. They're going to get offsides. They manage all to get back. But center ice manages to get the puck back. Now it's a foot race to number 15 from the Bulls and number 9, and a shot hits the left right blocker of the pad of the goalie. But center ice winds up covering it, skating the distance with number 14 from center ice, but number 9 from the Bulls recovers. Goes up speed. Try to get a pass to John Michael, but just covered up on. Center ice tried to take a shot, but wasn't even near the goal. It's just a battle for it here along the boards. Remember, center ice is wearing white today, and the Bulls are wearing blue. What a good pickoff. Now John Michael's got it. Here we go. It's a foot race. Can he get the breakaway? Oh, it's off the face mask. Oh, it's off the face mask of the goalie, but then there was another shot, almost. Muggs with almost breakaway. He had two center ice. Only man, that shot on goal and stopped by the goalie from center ice. So it brings the Bulls total of shots on goal 13. Center ice, one. Still. There's the face-off. Bulls keep it. Instead of sends it over to the defense. Win Laird makes a break for it. Dillon picks up, fires a shot, bounces, hits the goalie, and deflects. Center ice sends it back out to the neutral zone. Kellen McNutt trying to have McKenzie in there for the fight. Bray picks it up. Bulls are down by one here in the second with 9 minutes and 30 seconds left. But here we go. This could be something right here. But center ice comes up. Little stick check. Takes the puck away. McNutt makes a play, and it's a foot race. Ostler sends it over to goal. Oh, there's another shot, hits him in the face mask again by Thompson. That shot had some power on it. Bulls win the solid faceoff. Eric Gross sends it. It's another shot on goal. Eric Gross has it again. Callane takes a shot this time. It's wide to the left. Center ice trying to clear it out. Bulls, they get it out in neutral zone, but the Bulls are there. It's a fight for along the boards again. Aiden Skoglund, number 14, trying to play a little D right there. Number 10 takes a shot, and it's wide. You got only one shot on goal by center ice. Aiden Skoglund playing some defense. Players on the ground, Eglin. And there's one shot on the goal by center ice. Aiden playing a little Pele over there with his feet after he dropped his stick. And here we go. That's a foot race. Aiden's going. He can't quite beat the long legs of the giant number 28 from center ice. Foul on the boards. Michael Magavero comes out as champion of it. He's got a player on his left. He takes a shot that goes to wide. Now he's behind it. The net trying to make a play for the puck. John Michael's got the whole state of Alabama on top of him right now. Center ice comes up, number 10. On a stop by the goalie, almost gloved. Center ice has now tripled their shots on goal. Let's see what the call here is. So center ice has now tripled their shots on goal from 1-3. Bulls still down by one. Looks like we're going to have a penalty on center ice. Number 14. Number 14. The rest don't know what's going on. Yeah, number 14 Keller is going to be put into the box. Don't know the call. We'll go with tripping. That sounds about right. So the Bulls will be on a Publix power play for 1 minute and 30 seconds. Let's see if they can get a goal on this. I'm going to move the face off from center ice. John Michael's going to take the face off and they win it. Sends off Dylan Ray. Thompson doesn't like what he sees. And it's tied up along the boards. And John Michael has it. He's skating now. 3 goals yesterday in the loss to Knoxville. Loses the puck. Center ice trying to clear it. And it's a foot race to the puck. And center ice is there with a shot on goal, but all for naught. But can this give the Bulls some room with the aggressive penalty kill that center ice is having? Because now the Bulls might have some open ice. Sean Michael has it on the left board. He's fighting. And he takes a shot. It's not on goal. Dylan Ray picks up with a pass over to Thompson, but Thompson recoils, tries to get it back in. The Bulls are keeping pressure on. They got 20 seconds left on this power play. Kenzie sends it over. Gets it back. Takes a shot. It's deflected off the skate. Almost in. And a goal by the Bulls and a power play by number 23, Ray. And the game is tied up 1-1. Bulls had 10 seconds left on that Publix power play, but they wind up scoring big on it to give them a tied game to 1-1 here in the second with 5 minutes and 51 seconds left. Center ice takes the faceoff into the Bulls defensive zone. There's 63 joiners there trying to fight for the puck. Looks like Eric Ross is going to pick it up. He's in a battle. Thompson comes in and gives a little support with a stick check. Callane's tripped, but there's going to be no call on the play. And 63 joiners looking for some support. He's, it is out. Thompson making a play. Here we go. William Therrien trying to make a play for the putt. Doesn't get there in time. The Bulls keep it in, and it's sent back out. Two players go to ice, no penalty on the play. William Therrien skates to the puck, sends a pass over, but it's a little too far for the stick of Joyner. The Bulls get a line change. And they're called offsides. Oh. You want to wave at him? You want to wave at your husband? He's watching. He doesn't care about you, Sean. Ray comes up, sends a stick on it. Center ice has it now. And a shot and a save by the goalie from the Bulls. All tied up here in the second with 3 minutes and 58 seconds left. Bulls goal coming from a power play and the center ice goal coming from a breakaway. So defensive stand. Let's see if the Bulls can get in rhythm. Yesterday, the Bulls lost two games and center ice beat the Mad Hatters. I know 7-1. Might have been 8-1. I quit watching at 7. But here we go. And Skoglund making a play. He gets knocked down. Gets back up, has some words for the player, knocks him down. But John Michaels, again, swarmed with that puck. As soon as he touches it, they're on him. John Michaels trying to make a play to keep it in. Puck sent up the boards. Kellen McNutt falls, trying to skate with it. John Michaels has it now. He's the lone Bull in the zone. Excuse me, he had Aiden Skoglund there on his right. Wynn Laird comes in to keep it in, but it gets cut off from a pass from Wynn Laird. Aiden Skoglund skating with it. Him and Thompson are in. It's not going to be offsides, and a pass over. Oh, and a shot. Oh, and it's covered by the goalie. Aiden Skoglund coming off the ice with the awareness to give the puck to Thompson as he's coming off the ice, and Thompson with a beautiful shot high. The goalie just happened to pop up just enough if he wanted. It'd have been the third puck they would have caught in their face mask today. So, oh, it's behind what's behind the lag or the voice. Oh, here we go. This could be a Bulls goal. We're going to call it a save. Thompson doing everything in his power to get over there. More people probably coming in and getting on the Wi-Fi, so we're back. Scores 1-1. The goalie freezes the puck. 1 minute and 53 seconds left. Center ice, 5 shots on goal. Bulls, 18. One minute left to play. The Bulls win the faceoff. Ray sends it back over to Kenzie. Kenzie takes an airborne shot. And there's some confusion. No goal. Well, it looks like they're gonna take away the goal for high sticking. All right, so it looks like they haven't taken the goal away for high sticking. Looks like the goal will stand. The center ice skates with number 10. Trying to make something happen. The Bulls 2-1. There was some confusion about that goal would stand if it would be cast side due to high sticking. I understand we have a lag in the video. The reason is the Wi-Fi's not wanting to work, so I'm using my network. So sorry about that. John Michael has the puck. He stops behind his net, looks around, fires off past minute for Aiden Skoglin. Center ice keeps it back in. We're trying to apply pressure with his last 40 seconds. Pass to Aiden, he's making a fight for it. And he gets it out. And there's a pass over to Kellen McNutt. Kellen McNutt looks for Callahan again. He's taught up in a skate. And the Bulls, oh. There's two players down. There's going to be no penalty on it. Number 10 falls under his own accord. Kellen McNutt picks it up, skates with it, sends it over to John Michael Mugavaro. He skates with it. He's got 4 seconds to make something happen. He takes a shot, and it's over the net with 1 second left. And that's going to be the end of the second period. Bulls 2, center ice 1. Looks like we got probably a 14 second delay, maybe a minute delay, minute 14 second delay, as best I can come up with while trying to watch the video on Facebook Live. But Bulls 2, center ice 1. First goal of the game came very early. The score for the Bulls, the second goal was by Ray, and I believe that's going to be offsides by center ice. And I believe he had part in the first goal. I don't believe he scored it, but I believe he was the assist to that. I want to say it was Thompson on the first one. Not 100% positive, but there was some talk about that goal, second goal not standing for a high stick. There's a backhander to the net by number 10 center ice, and no goal. And it cleared out by Wynn Laird. It was in the crease. Just waiting for some picking, but Wynn Laird was there to clear it out. And Thompson skating up to the right-hand side of the ice with it. No offsides called. Trying to move this camera, and he takes a shot. And it's a goal. It is a Bulls goal. Man. So shots on goal, Bulls 20, center ice 5. 3-1 now with 12:16 left. in the third period. The sun has finally risen here in Pelham. Maybe that's got the Bulls pumping now that it's not darker than when the raid on Osama bin Laden happened. The Bulls win the faceoff with John Michael Mogavero taking it, trying to get around a defender. It's a battle for it. William Therrien comes in to help him out. Oh, and there's a shot, but a block and a good chance for a rebound by the Bulls. John Michael has it. He's looking for some support. Try to send a pass over. It's deflected off. It's almost a little tip into the net right there. It's knocked out to the neutral zone, and the Bulls are trying to recoil to get back in. If the Bulls keep playing like this, it's going to be a good season for them. We had those two losses yesterday, and we're going to have a tripping call on the Bulls. So that's the second of the Bulls' penalties for today. First one was from number Ray for interference, and now it's going to be John Michael Mogavero, number 88, for tripping. So the Bulls are now on the penalty kill. It's 11:18 left in the third. 1 minute, 30 second power play for center ice. Oh, the Bulls intercept it. Tell them they're going to try to skate out with it. Well, you got to ask yourself, do you play aggressive or conservative on this power play? I mean, on this penalty kill that the Bulls have. You try to go for the shorthand or you just try to kill time? Yeah, pass to the front of the net, but it's intercepted by Thompson. He tries to get it out, but Tank, number 9 from center ice, keeps it in. And it's cleared out. Kellerman Nutt gives chase. He's going to fight for it. Thompson clears it back out. Kellerman Nutt's trying to fight for it along the boards. Ooh, Dylan Ray with a little stick check. Going to have an offside. Again, there's a lag in the video. I apologize. We're on Wi-Fi. Then we had to get off that because the rink's starting to fill up. When it first started, there was about 20 people here. And now there's a bit more. So 40 seconds left on the penalty kill by the Bulls. Aiden Skoglund trying to come up and knock the puck out. Try to get that breakaway. Number 33. Oh, and a beautiful save. Aiden pass from Hostetter to Aiden Skoglund. It's a fight for it. Aiden Skoglund's got it. He's got room to skate. Number 9, Tank, comes with him. Knocks it out of his hand, though. Bulls doing a great job on this penalty kill. 17 seconds left. Number 10, center ice sends a pass, but it's deflected. Aiden gets a stick on it. He's trying to clear it out. Dominic Cowlane tries to get out, and there's a shot and a save. Oh, shot and a save by Bryce Croyle, the goalie, number 87. 9:45 left here to play in the third. Penalty kill is now over. The Bulls are back on full strength. Laird with a little tip up to Thompson to get it out. Off to Hostetter, who's skating in. He's double-teamed, loses the puck. But it is now in their zone. Hostetter gets tied up, but he just muscles his way out of it. Sends it to the slot to Thompson. Couldn't sell in time. When Laird takes a shot, and it's blocked by number 19 for center ice. The Bulls recover. Hostetter takes a shot, and he falls and shoots. The Bulls keep it in. Eric Grimes on defense. Takes an airborne shot by Southwest. Oh, man, what a shot. Laird takes a shot, keeps it back in. Center ice trying to make a play, but Eric Grimes is there. Got some fans in the crowd asking for an interference call, but Eric Grimes skates the distance, loses the clucking between two defenders. Bulls gonna try to get a line change. We got some cussing and carry on from a fan over here from center ice, but they're children. And the shot and a goal for number 10 from center ice. The game is now 2-3. Bulls, 8:28 left in the third. I expect to see number 10 from center ice have his ice time increase throughout the rest of this game. I believe he is the lone goal scorer for the team at this point. That's a fight for the puck. Okay, so Dylan has two and Raiden's got one. Okay. That's what I was thinking. I knew Dylan had that one. The Bulls are skating with it. Well, Theron trying to make a play. We got John Michael. Losing the puck. The one from center ice schedule. McKenzie recovers it. John Michael has it. And he takes a shot and it stops by the goalie. There's going to be a face-off. Penn center ice's defensive zone. 7 minutes and 32 left to play. The Bulls need to stay aggressive with the throttle on, not settle back. Center ice wins the faceoff. The 14th Skoglund trying to come in and make a play. Groz gets it, sends it up ice to Thompson, who sends it back up to Kellen McNutt, and he loses the puck, but sends it wide over that. Aiden Skoglund just couldn't make it there in time. Center ice has it looking for a pass in the skate of one of their players, but number 33 looks like their team picks up, takes a shot, and a stop and covered by the Bulls goalie. Bulls win the faceoff. John Michael wins it, sends it to Dylan Ray. Kenzie tries to fight for it. Oh, try to get a pass to slot. John Michael gets it up to Hostetter. Hostetter's got room. He's a big guy. Let's see if he can make it through. Logan loses the puck as gets caught on by three defenders. And number 10, like I said, watch out. No penalty on the play. Center ice fans looking for a tripping. Wynton Laird's got the puck. Sends it to John Michael. And it's offside. 2-3 with 6 minutes left to play here in the third. First goals for each side came from very interesting plays. Won a breakaway from center ice in the first 40 seconds of the game. And the Bulls' first goal coming a little bit later on a power play. But center ice picks it up. 33's trying to move in. Still has the puck. Takes a shot and it's off the face mask and clear it out. By the Bulls. I believe that was number 4, William Therrien. Cleared it out. Nope, it's Eric Ross, excuse me. Thompson recovers it in this zone. And here he goes, he's skating. And it's sticked away by number 91 from center ice. The Bulls keep it in the zone, though. And it's cleared back out. Graz is going to turn and sell it. Look and see what lanes he has open. And a beautiful pass over to William Therrien. Can't quite keep it. John Michael sends it into the zone. Joyner gives chase. Cowling's going to try to keep it in. He fires a shot. Oh! Kellen McNutt fires. Oh, almost a deflection goal. Off the stick of John Michael Mugavaro. The Bulls trying to keep it in. Center ice recovers. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to play. I told you number 10's ice time is going to increase, and it's wide of the net. It's going to be a Skogan with a little chip pass over to Magavero. Gets it past the defender. Kellen McNutt's looking for an open man. He finds John Michael. John Michael skates the slot. Takes a shot. Ooh, and a little chip off the bar. Aiden Skogan fights for it. Gets it. Keeps it in. John Michael gives chase. Bulls keep it in. Aiden sends it over to Ray. It gets a little bit of on the stick, but not enough. They're leaving 10 back to cherry pick with 3 minutes and 20 seconds left in the third period. Watch out for number 10. They're going to leave him behind the defense for a cherry picker goal. Aiden Skogan breaks up the play right in front of the net. Kenzie's there to give support. Now Aiden and Kenzie are both back there fighting for the puck. And they managed to get it. Kenzie sends it up to John Michael. And here we go. John Michael, Aiden Skogan on his left. He passes over. Ah, a little too much distance in between them. John Michael gets it from Aiden. Ah, he tries to get it, but he sticked. Watch out. Number 10 is going to try to get behind the defense right here for a cherry pick goal. And here it goes. Kyle Lane sees Eric Gross getting there to help out. Eric Gross there perfect on time off the bench to break up the play. Bulls have just a one goal lead in this game, trying to get their first victory of the weekend. The Bulls recover it. Thompson's trying to skate with it, keep it out. 2 minutes and 20 seconds left. Joyner recovers it, skates with it, takes a shot. Oh, and it's blocked by the goalie from center ice. Thompson takes a little shot. It's off the skate of William Therrien. Kenzie trying to keep it in. And 33 from beats a Bulls player, but Cowling's there to make the save. 1 minute and 40 seconds left to play. Bulls need to stay aggressive and get it out. Here we go. Thompson's got it out. He's got Joyner coming up with him. Pass over to Joyner. And a shot and a goal! Goal, Bulls. Joyner waiting for the pass. Good communication with a pass over from Thompson. What a goal. That brings the Bulls 4-2 over center ice here late in the third. 1-2-3 left in the third. Bulls fourth goal. If you believe in math that has connections and signs, 1-2-3-4, and that's going to be game. We had the faceoff. They're going to put number 10 in. They're going to try to get these two quick goals made up. And a shot, but a save by the goalie. Here we go. Logan Hostetter on his long. Can he get to the puck? And he makes it. Oh, it's a shot, but a save. Oh, and a late try by John Michael to recover that one puck to get it in there. Great effort. 50 seconds left in this game. when Laird keeps it in, has a shot, and the goalie's going to actually cover it. So we're going to have 48 seconds left. Bulls up 4-2. That last goal is beautiful. Thank you, guys. I thought that was pretty good. I'm pretty excited. I've had 4 hours of sleep, so this has been a pretty good day. And here we go. Bulls win the faceoff. Kellen McNutt trying to get over defense, but center ice knocks it out. 38 seconds left. Number 10's back on the ice for center ice. And he gets a goal. So 3-4 with 30 seconds left. Number 10 is going to be on for center ice for the remainder of this game. They're going to leave him behind the D to cherry pick a goal. Can the Bulls hold them off for 30 seconds? And center ice is pulling their goalie. So let's hope for an empty netter. That's like we'll have a timeout call. So that can bring up our sponsors. CSM, Champion Sports Medicine, is one of the Bulls' sponsors. Also with Publix and Southwest. They also would like to give a special shout out to Oak Mountain Lanes. Also, too, make sure you visit BirminghamBullsHockey.com. It's a goal line network website. They have merchandise. You can go there, check out their schedule, sponsors, merchandise, and more. You can get all the information concerning not only the 10U Bulls, but the other teams, all the way up to the 14U. So go check that out. And it looks like we're going to get back here in action with 30 seconds left. Empty net. Number 10, center ice, is going to take the faceoff. It's like he'll be pitted against John Michael. And here we go. The Bulls win it. Oh, is this it? Oh, that's a goal, Bulls! From Thompson. From almost the red line. Empty netter to put the Bulls up. 5-3 and polish off this victory with 20 seconds left. Looks like center ice is going to keep their goalie out again and try to tie this up. Number 10 is there going to take the face off. Substitute 33 for 14. They're sending the goalie back in. Parents giving their way. Center ice parents giving their way on how coaching should be done. Goalie's back in net for center ice. 20 seconds left. Bulls win the faceoff cleanly. John Michael. That's offsides. I don't know about all that. Okay. We'll say that was offsides. 13 seconds left. Center ice wins the faceoff. The Bulls recover. John Michael skates with it into the zone, and time's ticking down. And this is going to be game. And the Bulls win 5-3. What a game. Did not give up. What a game. Bulls are down early and quick with a breakaway goal by number 10 from center ice. But got back in the game with the power play and never let back up. And that empty netter really sealed the deal. So here we go with the handshakes. And the Bulls are now 1-2 in the weekend with one more game left. Let's see if they can break even. They will play the Mad Hatters, I believe, at 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. Well, we will be back live for that. But here you have it. First Bulls win of the weekend here early in the morning.